Hello, this is Almir. Today we're going to continue the DynamoDB series, things you will not learn in regular courses and tutorials. Last time I mentioned something important about NoSQL and Dynamo, and I'm going to make that statement again. Instead of thinking how the data should be stored, think about how the data is being searched or predict how it will be searched. This is a very important statement in designing NoSQL tables and DynamoDB tables. Let's move on to today's topic. Today's topic is about designing your table in such a way that you don't fall in the trap and designing in such a way how you used to do it in the relational databases. So do not try to do SQL relational design within DynamoDB. It is okay to have redundancy. However, be careful about the lists of maps or JSON objects within the DynamoDB table. It has to be a finite list. Otherwise, you need to have a mechanism to strip the rolling data out or start storing links and pointing to S3. These are very important two statements, and the best way to explain this is by showing you an example. Pretend you have a customers table in DynamoDB, and this customers table has a hash key customer ID. And then you have other information about this customer: title, first name, last name, date of birth, and then you have the list of addresses, and then you have the phone number and the usual, like for example, create an update date for the overall item in DynamoDB table for your record. So now, if you zoom in on this section here, which is the list of addresses, this is really a list of maps or a list of JSON objects within the item on your within your DynamoDB item. Here I have the address ID, which is the one which is a GUID, and then I also have address type, and this is my current address. Then I have another address ID, and that address type is previous. And then third address ID, and the address type is previous. So I have three addresses in this list. Now, the details of these addresses have to be stored somewhere else. So let's assume I designed a table, addresses table in DynamoDB, and this table holds everybody's addresses, include my addresses and other customers' addresses. So in this case, this item here is one item in DynamoDB. Pretend we were looking in DynamoDB and I just pasted the results or JSON from Dynamo into my text editor here. So we're looking at one address here that has an address ID. So this addresses table would have a hash key of address ID and then some other information about the address. So this happens to be my first address or the current address in the customer record that I showed you earlier. The second address based on the address ID is my second address in my list, and this is the third address in the customer record that I showed you. And then we have other people's addresses here. For example, I have another address. We don't know who it belongs to, but it's stored in this addresses table in DynamoDB. So now let's go back to this customer record here and pretend you built a customer's API on top of this table. And clients can call your API and say, give me a customer record, and they pass the customer ID, and your API is supposed to return all the customers, all the information about this specific customer. So you can return all this information that resides here, but now when it comes to returning the address details, you don't have those details in this table. You have the address ID and address type, but you don't have the rest of the address details. So now you have to make a call. Let's assume addresses table is part of an addresses API. You have to make an API call into the addresses API, say, go get me the records or the details on the address ID, and then you pass the address ID. Or even if the addresses table was part of your customer's microservice, which is in the gray area, but let's assume it was even a part of your customer service, you still have to make a call into the addresses DynamoDB table and fetch record for this address, second record, and third record. So if you have a customer that has an average of three addresses, if you're making 1 million, if somebody's calling your API, customer's API 1 million times during a day, you have to make on average 3 million calls into the addresses API or addresses table to fetch the details on those addresses. So you can return the full result to the person who called the customer's API. So this is not efficient from performance point of view, and this is not efficient from the cost point of view, because you have to provision the addresses table, which is your secondary table, to accept 3 million calls. So that's going to cost you more. Plus, customers API has to make calls into addresses API or addresses table, and that's adding more milliseconds to your response. So overall performance is bad. So how do you get around this in the NoSQL and DynamoDB? What my recommendation is you design the customer's table where you have the hash key as the customer ID, for example, in this case. You have the customer details here. And then let's say you have the list of addresses, but instead of putting the address IDs here, you put the full detail about this address. City, county, zip code, whatever you need. The second address contains all the details you need. The same thing for the third address. So you really have a list of maps here or JSON objects. So when somebody calls your customer's API and they say, give me the details on customer ID, 123, or whatever this GUID is, I can provide all the details because all the details are sitting in my customer's table. I don't have to go fetch address details from some other table. So from performance point of view, this is much better. From cost point of view, this is much better. But there is some things you have to watch out for in this design. Obviously, having three addresses in a single item in DynamoDB, it's okay. DynamoDB has a limitation of 400 kilobytes per item or per record. So if you have 3 or even 10 addresses, that's still fine. But let's say if somebody told you that your design or your business logic doesn't stop anybody from adding 200 addresses here, obviously there's no, you're not going to have a cases where people live in 200 addresses, but there could be some other table where that might be possible. But in the customer's table, it may not be possible. But let's assume you needed to add 200 addresses here, then this design would not work. You may exceed the 400 KB limit on the overall item. But then you can also solve it different ways. You can work with the business and say, okay, I'm only gonna keep 10 addresses for this person at a time. So your API has business logic that every time it saves data into or updates data in this DynamoDB table, it will strip out anything beyond 10 addresses. Or you can have a rule, 10 addresses or 5 years of addresses, whichever rule kicks in first. That's how you would control the size of this list. So the recommendation is, yes, it's okay to have a little bit of redundancy, but you have to control the list here, and you have to keep it finite. The business logic in your API needs to control the size of this list. So going back to the document here, to just summarize quickly, do not try to do SQL relational design within DynamoDB. It is okay to have redundancy, but watch out for the list of maps or JSON objects. You have to have a finite list. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe on my channel, or you can visit my blog, almirscorner.com. Thank you.